we will observe how cryptographic systems can be categorized in different dimensions. Now, when we consider all cryptographic systems, they can be categorized along three independent dimensions. Now, what are they? They are the type of operations used for transforming the plain text to ciphertext, right, based on the operations used. And the second one is number of keys used. And the third way is the way in which the plain text is processed. Right. So all cryptographic systems, all kinds of encryption and decryption algorithms can be categorized in these three ways. Now let's talk about the operations, the type of operation. So when we talk about the type of operation, under that there are two ways. The first one is known as substitution. And the second one is known as transposition. Right? So what is substitution? When we talk about substitution, let's take a few examples. Let us talk about Caesar's cipher. Now in Caesar's cipher, a given alphabet A is replaced by B. Another alphabet B is replaced by E and so on. Right? So this is Caesar's cipher where the key K equals 3. Right? So here the alphabet A is substituted with another alphabet D. The alphabet B is substituted with another alphabet E. Now the same thing happens with Playfair, wherein we have two alphabets which are substituted by two other alphabets, and the substitution is dependent on the key matrix, the 5x5 key matrix used. Right? So two alphabets taken at a time, plain text, is replaced by two other alphabets of the ciphertext. So we have substitution taking place. Now let's talk about DES. Right? So in DES, what happens? There's a 64-bit plain text. If I use one particular key, K1, I get a particular 64-bit ciphertext. Right, for the given key K1. So K1 being the same, if the plain text is P1, it is always substituted with the ciphertext C1 for the key K1. And this substitution remains the same. Right? Because it is a one-to-one transformation. It is a one-to-one mapping, we should say. Right? So this plain text would give this specific ciphertext, 64-bit ciphertext. For decryption, this particular 64-bit ciphertext would give this particular plain text, because we need to decrypt and get back the plain text, right? So again, we can consider this to be a process of substitution where a 64-bit data is substituted with another 64-bit data, right? So all these methods fall under the category of substitution, right? Where an element of plain text is mapped to another element of ciphertext. It may be single alphabets or characters, two or three alphabets or characters. Say in Playfair we have two, in case of Hill it can be 2, 3, 4 and so on. In case of DES you can have a 64-bit plain text which is substituted with another 64-bit ciphertext. So this is substitution cipher. Now what about transposition? Now in transposition, the elements of plain text are rearranged. Right? The simplest example is the rail fence cipher. Right? So if we consider the plain text as cryptographic systems. So let the plain text be cryptographic systems, right? So in RailFin cipher, what is done? We consider two parallel lines or rails, and the plain text is written alternately along these two lines, right? So you have CR, YP, TO, GR, A, PH, IC, right? And this continues for the entire plain text. SYS, TEMS. So now we read the first row, the alphabets written on the first line, which is CYTGAH, CYTM, and then along the second, which is RPORPISSES. Right? So here there is no substitution happening. The characters of the alphabets present in the plain text are retained in the ciphertext, but the order is changed, right? So this is referred to as transposition. So the way in which the operation is performed, it can either be substitution or transposition. The next category happens to be the number of keys used. So based on the number of key used, so it can be one key, right? So this is referred to as symmetric cipher, but you're called a single key or secret key or conventional encryption, right? They are all synonymous. And if the sender and receiver use different keys, it is referred to as asymmetric. Or two key or public key encryption. Right? So we have already seen what a symmetric cipher is and what an asymmetric cipher is in the previous lecture videos. In case of a symmetric cipher, very briefly, encryption algorithm uses a key K1. The same key is used by the decryption algorithm, right? So it is one single key which is used both for encryption and decryption. But whereas in the case of asymmetric or public key encryption, there are two keys. One is referred to as the public key and the other one is referred to as the private key, right? So the public key is made public, whereas the private key is kept private. So using both the sender and the receiver, using the public key of themselves and the others, for example, if there are two users A and B, A generates his own public key and private key, B generates his own public key and private key. A would share his public key to B. B would share his public key to A. Right? So A would use his private key and B's public key, and the process of encryption would happen. Similarly, B would use his private key, so there should be KRB, and A's public key, and the process of encryption would happen, right? So this is asymmetric cipher or two key or public key encryption. So next, we talk about the way in which the plain text is processed. We have block processing or stream. So So in block processing, a block of plain text is given to the encryption algorithm, producing a block of ciphertext. Right? In case of Hill cipher, right? If the encryption matrix is a 3x3 matrix, the dimension is 3x3. So we take a block of plain text, that is 3 alphabets of the plain text, producing 3 alphabets of ciphertext. In case of SDES, a block of bits, 8 bits of plain text, is taken at a time by the algorithm, producing 8 bits of ciphertext. So similarly, in case of DES, a block of 64 bits is taken by the encryption algorithm, producing another block of 64 bits. So this is referred to as a block cipher. In case of stream cipher, let's talk about Caesar cipher. So in Caesar cipher, what is done? One alphabet is taken at a time, producing one alphabet of ciphertext. So alphabet by alphabet, the encryption is performed, right? The same happens in the case of affine transformation, alphabet by alphabet, okay? Or if you have an algorithm which takes in element by element of the plain text, a single element of the plain text is taken by the algorithm, producing a single element of ciphertext, that is referred to as stream cipher. So cryptographic algorithms or systems can be categorized based on the operation. We have substitution and transposition. In brief, what is substitution? The plain text is substituted by the ciphertext, okay? Right? The plain text elements are substituted by the ciphertext elements, that is substitution. What is transposition? In transposition, the elements of plain text are rearranged in some order. Next, the second category is the keys. If one single key is used, it is referred to as symmetric. It is also called a single key. It is also called a secret key or classical encryption. Now, if you have two keys used, one is the public and the private, it's referred to as asymmetric or two key or public key encryption. The way in which the plain text is processed, right? If one block of elements of plain text is taken by the encryption algorithm at a time, producing one block of ciphertext, it is referred to as a block cipher. When we talk about stream cipher, it processes input elements continuously, producing one element of ciphertext at a time. Right? So this is how all cryptographic systems can be categorized.